Hi, everybody. Larry Bailey here with Mastering Encompass, and I want to explain to you what Encompass business rules are all about. That's what this video is going to show you, exactly why we need business rules, how each business rule affects the Encompass experience, and what to do about too many business rules. I can tell you all kinds of story. Let's dig in here. So the very first business rule we're going to go over is a loan folder business rule, and these business rules are what prevent you from creating loans where you're not supposed to or moving loans into folders before they're actually ready. So some great ones here are that in this particular on screen, some great ones that you typically work with are like a prospects folder or my pipeline. Now, one of the things that I want to make sure you remember is less is more. If you're part of my Mastering Encompass Free Users course, you'll always hear me talk about maintenance. The reason why we have these loan folders listed in this loan folder business rule is because up in loan setup, we've got all kinds of folders that you see here. Sometimes you don't need so many. Remember, everything that you create gives a butterfly effect to something else. So if you have too many loan folders because you're always either having years in your loan folders or different kinds of loan folders that you just don't know where your files are, you definitely want to get this addressed and make sure things are as clean as possible and as concise as possible. Now, milestone completion business rules. Now, we're all kind of used to this. If you're used to Encompass, you're definitely used to milestone completion business rules. These are the requirements that you can create in order to make sure that your team member goes ahead and either allows for required docs to come in, required tasks to come in, required fields to come in, or even custom code that gives you a response if you've got something missing, a typed out message. This is a very age-old kind of business rule in Encompass. It's very common for companies to have the majority of rules written between milestone completion and one other business rule type I'll share with you here in a second. What you need to make sure you understand is that these come through workflow. So if you find that you're working in your Encompass and you're constantly having to do things, quote unquote, just to be able to kind of trick the system in order to be able to finish a milestone, that's a red flag. And I definitely would encourage you to check with your Encompass administrator to give them that feedback, because they may not realize it's happening, but they can definitely do something about it. Now, if you're working with TPO loans, third-party loans, you're going to have a business rule called loan action completion. So on the TPO Connect website, you're going to have the ability to complete actions if you're the correspondent or the wholesale broker for the lender whose TPO Connect site you're on. In Encompass, we can make sure that the TPO client is actually doing things before we allow the TPO client to complete actions on the TPO Connect site, hence the name loan action completion. So similar to what we saw with milestone completion inside the business unit itself internally on the milestone worksheet inside of the Encompass, either web or Encompass desktop user interface, the loan action completion is all about doing things as a TPO client on the TPO Connect site. So same thing goes. If you're hearing feedback from your TPO clients that they're doing things that they really don't need to do or shouldn't need to do in order to finish an action, this is where you'd come. All right, now we're going to get to a business rule called field data entry. And this sounds kind of weird, but what it's basically doing is it's not allowing you to enter information into a field until the criteria has been met. There's one other thing that you've got to know. And if you're in Encompass and you click the e-disclosure button and you get a message or an error or something that says you're not allowed to generate those disclosures until some other condition has been met, that's a field data entry business rule. And so anytime that, as an administrator, anytime that you need to control what type of data is being input into a particular field or what kind of data is being shown in a drop-down list of a particular drop-down field, you can do all that within field data entry. It's very helpful in the micro workflow kind of management, making sure that you understand exactly what you're allowing to have happen, exactly when you want to let it happen. All right, so let's get to a crowd pleaser fan favorite, field triggers. This is the number one business rule that's used in every Encompass. It's the age-old cause and effect. It's the age-old, when this thing happens, I want that thing to happen. That's a field trigger. So it's widely used. You can create all kinds of consequences or results from the actions that were taken. And these kinds of rules actually exist not only here in field triggers, but also on Encompass web settings, as well in workflow rules, which is a whole different conversation, a whole different story. But when we're focusing on field triggers, again, it's one of those things, if you're in your Encompass environment, all of a sudden something happens, you're like, how the heck did that happen? It's probably because of something that either you did or you triggered by doing something that you did. That's a field trigger. Okay, automated conditions, not what you think, not at all. What this does is it creates an automated condition list using standard conditions. So if your Encompass is still using standard conditions, what you're going to understand here is that the automated condition simply builds together an aggregated list of standard conditions. So if you're in your E folder and you're allowed to add conditions, and you go down to the radio button where it says add automated conditions, Encompass is going to come here to this set of rules. It's going to build that aggregated list for you to either manually choose from or just add all, which is what I typically recommend in the training that I provide, in the core training for Mastering Encompass for users, for underwriters. And that's going to come in here. Now, automated enhanced conditions, totally different. This is truly automated conditions. So if you're using enhanced conditions already, thumbs up to you. Second thing you've got to do now is build an automated enhanced conditions set here, and then use workflow rules to actually automatically trigger these conditions to go into the E folder automatically. Not to be confused with what I just went over. This one's legit straight into the E folder. No third-party tech needed. It just updates. It's that awesome. Let's get into persona access to fields. Now, similar to what I said earlier about field data entry, where we're trying to control the user experience, persona access to fields is specifically addressing what can the persona do with a specific field if they have full edit access to the loan file. So some examples of this typical are if the rate is locked, like up in like this rule right here. If the rate is locked, we don't want specific personas to be able to update specific fields given that condition. And the list goes on and on. This is a classic workflow enhancement kind of rule where we like to make sure that the experience that the team member has is controlled and defined. Now, the persona access to loans business rule is more macro based. In other words, it's bigger picture stuff. Should the persona have edit rights or view only rights or some middle ground of partial edit rights to a loan file? That's what this is. So some good examples of this are when the loan is submitted to underwriting, somebody's ability to interact or edit the loan is changed. Same thing if the loan's closed or the loan's been disclosed for loan officers. These are all kinds of typical examples of using persona access to loans business rules to really control how the workflow is managed inside of Encompass. Going back to TPO for a second, you've got persona access to loan actions. Now, where we saw loan action completion a minute ago, in terms of not allowing a TPO team member to be able to finish an action or complete an action until something exists, what we're saying here is, are we even going to let a particular persona even access the action in order to complete it? So again, if you haven't heard this already from me, workflow always comes before technology. You want to make sure that you understand exactly what the workflow is before you go building business rules. Pretty please, sugar on top, because if you don't understand your workflow, building rules on top of that is probably going to create more problems than it's going to solve, and I definitely don't want that for you. Okay, let's get into role access to documents. I find this is one of the more confusing business rules for everyone in Encompass, and what's important to understand is because it's role access to documents, you need to make sure that anytime that you go and add a role to your Encompass platform, you've got to remember to come down here, because if you don't, you're going to end up with something that you really don't want, which is a little bit of confusion. So basically, anytime a particular role creates a document inside of any loan file, automatically at that moment, the following roles have access. Now, access here means, can they see it? Do they see the document? It's not about what they can do with the document, just can they see it? And if we get into that protected role, protected document workflow I explained earlier in another video for personas. By the way, if you haven't seen that video, check out the video for personas in one of the links in the description or on screen right now if my superb web team is putting that up there for you. So when you go through and you look at the role access to documents, if you notice that somebody says they can see the document and then somebody else says they can't in the same loan file, it's probably a role access to document business rule that you need to go review. Moving on to input form lists. Now, these rules are kind of old. They've been around, input form list business rules have been around for a long, long time. And what it does is it appends the list of input forms at the very bottom based upon these business rules. It appends the input forms that exist at the bottom. You can see that there are some that are active. I can tell you it's become less and less common for companies to use this. It's more common for companies just to build out input form lists that are needed regardless of these specific conditions. So you might not notice any difference to your input form list, even if you've got these business rules. Now, loan form printing is all about restricting the user's ability to print something. So the typical examples here are, you cannot print a closing disclosure until certain fields are completed, or you cannot print a loan estimate once a closing disclosure has been generated, or you can't print a statement of denial until the loan's actually denied. These are very classic examples. Your team should actually have some of these very basic examples in play and active, hopefully. That's up to you. When it comes to print auto selection, what you're doing here is, under specific conditions, you're allowing the team to have print forms automatically added to the print window so your user cannot forget to have them printed over on the right. So it's more of a training assist here. It is not something that a lot of companies use, but I do encourage you to check it out, especially if you've got very specific custom print forms that are being added to the print list under specific conditions. So this allows your team to see what's going on when it comes to printing. Appraisal order management. Now, the screen's black here just because if you've got something that you're doing with appraisals, you're typically using an AMC. If you are leveraging the Encompass platform for appraisal ordering directly, your administrator will know exactly how to set those rules up, and you can go from there. Rounding out the bottom here, the LO compensation rule. This is more of a business rule identifying what fees are included in LO compensation. And last but not least, with collateral tracking, it's kind of a weird business rule, but it basically allows you to set up the collateral tracking tool inside of Encompass with your defaulted information. Gang, that's it. That's the entire section of business rules from top to bottom. And what I wanted to make sure is that you learn everything that's possible, because in Encompass Desktop, we have all of those rules, but then also in Encompass Web, we have an entire set of other rules. I teach all of this in the Mastery Encompass for Admins course that I want to make sure you're aware of so that you can best know how to leverage your entire Encompass platform natively from top to bottom, inside and out, and making sure you've got the best possible experience with your Encompass platform. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to find out more videos, and go ahead and check the playlist that we have to find all information, everything about Encompass, to help you out today. Thank you very much.